Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Good to see all of you again on this beautiful Sunday morning where we're supposed to have service, in-person service in the main auditorium, but restrictions have made it still impossible. So we are here again at the Riverside, and it's such a blessing. So you are all welcome once again. We thank the Lord for the opportunity He has given us to worship in spite of the season and the difficulties of the moment. But I'm confident that God will do something amazing in your life. And what He has done for our brother Nicodemus, He will do for you too. If He do for him, He go do for you. If He do for him, He go do for you. If He do for you, He go do for him. If He do for me, He go do for you. If He do for you, He go do for me. Clap your hands unto Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Just pray and ask God to touch you today. It's a wonderful time to be in the to be alive and to be in His presence. We pray that you will never be the same again as you receive the word of God. May His word bring transformation. May His word bring life-changing encounters. May His word bring steps, advancements in our steps in life. In the name of Jesus. Just begin to pray. Ma zandi baradase. Oh, ria mashanda la baba. Rabakaya. Yes, Lord. Do shende rebeka. But everybody at home, please join us as we pray. If you are sitting, it will be good to stand to just give yourself a change in posture, a change in position, and God will bless you. Marande ko sande ibarandeli, rabato sande baradage, sebendere mene, janda barale, ramanande zibalale. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, He is. He is our God. Masande kada, rabadaba, nastamande, liberanande, zimaranande, zimaranande. Blessed be God, who alone makes all things possible. Who alone makes all things possible. Blessed be your name. Zamanoria brakande limenale. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Have your way. Have your way. In the mighty name of Jesus. Nasande badara la mama. Lift your hands wherever you are. Lift your hands. We are going to tell the Lord, show me your way that I may walk with you. Yes, Lord. Show me your way. I want to walk with you on a daily basis. And this morning, as His word comes, He will show us His way that we may walk in His paths. Yes.
Show me your way.
If you can sing it, just sing it.
That I may walk with you. Show me your way.
I put my hope
in you.
The cry of my heart,
the cry of my heart is to love you more, to live with that touch of your hand, stronger each day. Show me your way.
Tell the Lord, it's a song, it's a prayer.
Show me your way.
Oh,
that I may walk with you.
Show me your way.
Show me your way.
I put my hope.
The cry of my heart, the cry of my heart is to love you more, live with the touch of your hand, stronger each day. Show me your way.
That's your prayer. That's your song.
Show me your way. Show me your way. I put my hope in you. The cry of my heart is to love you more. To live with the touch of your hand. Stronger each day. Oh, show me your way. Show me your way.
Give me the wave of your hand. Yes.
That I may walk with you. Show me your way. Show me your way. I put my hope in you. The cry of my heart is to love you more. To live with the touch of your hand. Stronger each day. The cry of my heart is to love you more. Live with the touch of your hand. Stronger each day. Show me your way.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this morning. His hand is going to touch you, be stronger upon you today, right in your home, right in your shop, right in your car, right in the taxi, as you are listening either on Sweet Melodies, you are listening by YouTube, you are listening by Facebook. God is coming through to you wherever you are. His hand will touch you, his mighty power will reach out to you, and you will never be the same again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you as we come to your word. We are asking for the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, the eyes of our understanding being enlightened, that we may know the hope of your calling and what is the riches of the glorious inheritance you have in the saints, and the exceeding greatness of your power which you wrought in Christ when you set him, you raised him from the dead and set him at your own right hand. Have your way. Teach us your ways that we may walk in your path all the days of our lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Clap your hands. Clap your hands. God bless all of you that are watching. God bless you. You may be seated if you are still standing. I see so many people making comments, joining in. God bless you. Oh, wonderful. God is going to bless you. God is going to touch your life and increase you greatly as you partake in this. Remember that if you have not yet liked our Makarios Church-HQ page, the Makarios Church-HQ page, please like it and follow. Two things you must do. You like the page and you follow the page. So you see follow somewhere on the page, click on it, and then you see also like is like, you know, a thumbs up sign that is there. When you click on it, it means you like it. And then share it with your friends and encourage them to also like it and follow it and be blessed. Our old page, which was the Qedesh, is now no longer in use. We have discontinued it and we are on the Makarios Church-HQ. So it's a new site, so you need to renew your love for the ministry by liking and following. I know you've liked my page, Bishop Eddy Addy page, and some people also have gone on my, you know, when I started Facebook, I had Eddy Addy, you know, and it allows you only 5,000 friends, and I have more than 5,000 friends. So I've reached the limit of my friends who can like that page. So if you go up to the Eddy Addy page, you wouldn't get any chance to be my friend, even though you are my friend. So please go on to the Bishop Eddy Addy page And then there too, you will have an encounter. So if you are the Eddy Addy page, you are also watching right now. God bless you. You will never be the same again. I love you all. I'm praying for you. I'm believing God for you, that God will bless you, God will establish you, and that in this season you will not die from the corona. I know several people who have called me. I went and I tested positive for corona, and then somehow God has delivered them from that condition, because it's not possible that you'll be taken down by the coronavirus. You didn't say an amen. Your amen was weak at home. Are you intimidated? You know, you don't want to say amen and show that you are a believer in the house. Say the amen properly and establish it. I say it is not possible for corona to take you down in Jesus' name. Say amen.
Amen.
I really miss all of you in church. I'm looking forward to your coming. I know it's not possible now. I mean, the restrictions that I've been given as such that it's not possible. So please ensure that you stay at home. Don't come to church. There's no service live here. It's on the internet. So when you come to church, you won't find anybody. So please don't come and say you came all the way and there was nobody there. So please pay attention and flow with us. We'll be online on Sundays and on Tuesdays. Tuesday evening, 7:30. Sundays, as you already know, from 10 a.m. And then on YouTube, I normally come around 10:30. So please be patient with us. If you see any time which is not like the time that you're expecting, it's a typographical error. I'm sure you have made a few mistakes, so allow them to also make a few mistakes. God bless you. Now let's get into the word. Are you ready for that one?
Yes.
We are still preaching on labor to be blessed. This is a very important subject that is taking you from zero to hero.
Yes.
Proverbs chapter 23 and verse number 4, the Bible says, labor not to be rich. Cease from your own wisdom. Our own wisdom tells us to labor for riches. But God's wisdom says labor for a blessing. Proverbs 10:22 says, for the blessing of the Lord, the blessing, maketh rich. So don't labor for riches, but labor for something that also makes rich.
Amen.
And the blessing of the Lord makes rich, and then, and he addeth no sorrow with it. May you prosper without sorrow.
Yeah.
You have prospered, you have a nice car, you have a nice house, but you don't have peace in the marriage. You have peace in the marriage, you have children who are first in class, but you don't have money. So the two of them don't go, they are like mutually exclusive events with a joint probability of zero. Only mathematicians understand that. I tell you, but I want you to know something, that God is teaching us how to attract blessings. You know, when I was even coming this morning to the studio, and I think I gave a trotro guy, you know, I allowed him to enter. You know how sometimes they don't allow people to enter, taxis, trotros, if they are going, and you force, as if you are challenging them for passengers, you know. And I felt in my heart as I allowed him to come that the guy was blessing me in the car. You know, sometimes they just wave. You know, they say, okay, thank you. And sometimes somebody really feels hot when you allow him to enter. He will say, God bless you. You see, you may not know what it is. But there are some people, no matter what, it's like they must go first. They will never allow anybody to come. So you are laboring to be first, but labor for a blessing. So that somebody can even say, God bless you on the roadside, on the road, on the road. So labor for something that attracts blessings. Don't always look for money. Anyway, so we began to look at so many things. We can't have time to go through that on the podcast. All the messages are there. If you are joining us for the first time, you can go to the Bishop Eddy Addy podcast, either on Podcast Addict on Android or podcast on iTunes, and then you will get all the messages for free. We don't sell messages. We've stopped merchandising messages for a long time, so it's all free. You can also get it free on YouTube in case you want to see my face and see whether I'm the real person who is talking. You can see my face on YouTube. It's there for free. Okay? So please follow along and let the message be a blessing. Today, I want to conclude on labor for revelation. Labor for revelation. Remember that revelation is a surprising and interesting and important fact that is made known to people. God has many surprising and interesting and important for your life facts to help you go to the next level. That is why about two weeks ago we had Americans go to space. There's a whole station, they call it ISS, International Space Station. It's moving like how the earth is moving, but it moves faster than the earth. And it's orbiting or going around the earth every 19 minutes. It goes round. And the people go there to go and be out of the earth to do various scientific experiments. The other day I was watching them, they were doing an experiment on plants to see how plants perspire. Do you see that plants perspire, and they are trying to use it to develop something that will help curb droughts and dryness in vegetation? Like, it can predict that there's going to be drought, or it can, they want to find some, you see, they are looking for surprising, interesting and important for our life facts on earth. And they have had to go to the moon. It's like they are laboring for a revelation, or as normal scientists would say, a discovery. You see, because every scientific discovery has led to a great advancement in human life. Since we discovered phones, I mean, people can't even walk straight. There used to be a time when there was no mobile phone. I mean, in my time, I've been alive to see all these things come to our world. There was a time there was no mobile phone. And there was a time it was only landlines. You see, now I don't know of anybody who has a landline. Do you know anybody who has a landline? I don't know any landline. Like a line that you dial, crane, 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 and then it passes through YSR before it gets to somebody's house. I know no one who has it. You know, because they discovered mobile. So that it's like you carry with you a phone and you are walking with it. And now it has become a danger even to our lives. Do you see? People are looking at their phones as they are going, texting, what's texting them, before they realize that, hey, I'm not in my house, I am on the road. Are you listening to me? And so God also, in his word and in relating with you, has many interesting, surprising, and important facts for your life, for your ministry, for your business, for your relationships, for your health. Yes. The day a revelation hits you, a revelation, you know, the Bible calls it light. Anybody who has this type of light, something is revealed to you, it's like a light has come on in your head about something, a fact, a way of living. You say, wow, it makes you change the things you were doing before you knew that you got the revelation. And from that moment, you will start to shine in a way you have never shone. You are going to shine. Amen. I said you are going to shine. Amen. So, Bible says God teaches us in Isaiah 48. He says, I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit. Or it means, to profit means to prosper or to become valuable. Yes, to ascend. You are going to ascend. Amen. You have remained at a certain low level for a long time, but you are going to ascend. Amen. God will make you ascend. Amen. God will teach you to ascend.
Amen.
That is why the Bible says that, number one, he gave a revelation to Jacob, and that made him to prosper and ascend. He told Laban, when I came, you had very few sheep and very few lambs. But because of me, all your things have multiplied. So he had an agreement that he would give some of the sheep and the rams to him. And the way it was is that if the color is spotted, striped, or whatever, he would give. So when they got the agreement, Laban actually gave the spotted and this into his sons. It's like there was none left for Jacob. He gave them to his sons, and he put about 3 days' journey between them. So it's like you are starting from minus 3 days. But a person who has been blessed, it doesn't matter which backside of the desert you are. It doesn't matter how far behind you are. Your brothers may even get inheritance ahead of you. Or your brother, and you know that not everybody, you see, people feel that once you get inheritance, you are going to prosper. Many people inherit things, they never prosper with it. So stop fighting for inheritance. Quarreling over small one house that they have given you and your siblings. Everybody is quarreling. There are only 3 rooms and you are 7. Brother, leave it. No, take the sitting room. So if you take the sitting room, the people who have the rooms, how would they entertain their visitors? You like quarreling over things that you shouldn't quarrel. Rather, no, the Bible says, fight for something that is called a blessing. And Jacob was one to fight for blessing all the days of his life. And he kept fighting. He kept fighting until his father said, you are blessed. You are blessed above your brothers. Your brothers will serve you. Nations will bow to you. And those who bless you are blessed. And those who curse you are cursed. So when he landed in his uncle Laban's house, his mother's brother, he was a blessed man. Now, a blessed man, if you put him at the back, he will come to the front. If you push him under, he will come on top. You are that type of blessed man. I say you are that type of blessed man. Stop quarreling in the office and working against people to rise above them. That's not how we get blessed. We don't get blessed by trying to work under people, go and talk about them to the bosses, say something to your pastor, say something to some brother, be somewhere so that he will not like that sister and he will like you. So you come and fix there when you know that his eyes are trained on her. And you are working, talking, saying things about the person so that he will not look at the person with favor anymore, but he will look on you for favor. It won't be long. If that person is a blessed person, you will see that he that was last becomes first. And he that was first rather becomes last. Labor for revelation.
Amen.
Labor for revelation.
Amen.
I said labor for revelation.
Amen.
Jacob said, when the brothers said, later they realized, this man, he has been blessed. Everything that he has is our father's own. And Jacob saw that his uncle was now, when he looks at him, he's not happy. Then he said, it's not my fault. We came to an agreement. You even didn't leave me any of the ring, strict and stripe, this thing that we agreed on. You took everything and gave to your children. Now, God, he said, but God did not allow you to do me evil. God, but God. That's where you must go. But God. That's why you're a Christian. You see that you don't really follow God. You are some religious person. Even as we are speaking, you are a Christian, but you see that you don't really like going on online for the services. But you like going on online to watch movies. And useless Nigerian movies. Hey. Oh, you are not getting the message.
We are getting it.
Ask your neighbor, are you following the message?
Are you following the message?
Yes. So, stay on course as I'm preaching. God is about to revolutionize your life.
Amen.
So Jacob, he told them, he said, look, God is the one who gave me a dream. The angel of the Lord gave me a revelation in a dream, by a dream, and showed me what was going to happen. So when they were mating, he took, I don't know, by that revelation, he took a stick, like a branch, and then he removed the back in an alternate fashion so that it looks striped in front, and he planted them in front of the sheep. God gave him a revelation for genetic engineering. You don't understand genetic engineering. It's like you are able to change the sex of a child before it is born. You are able to change the color before it is born. You are able to change the intelligent quotient of the child, the IQ, before it is born. And Jacob had that. He said, it was an angel that showed me in the night vision. So when the sheep were mating and they were looking at black and white, 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 then it entered into their womb, and the children they were conceiving were now ring streak, black and white, spotted, ring streak, grizzled. She said, hey, the man has given his children all the spotted ones, and the only white sheep are left. But somehow, when they gave birth, striped ones, spotted ones, ring streaked ones, grizzled ones, he said, hey, what happened? How did they say, well, then this one is for Jacob, 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 this one is for Jacob. By the time they realized, Jacob had more sheep than his uncle. And the uncle said, I have learned by experience that the Lord has even blessed me for your sake. When we come to the blessing of association, you will see attracting a blessing by association. Labor for association, because there is a blessing that comes through association. You will see that. So brothers and sisters, labor for revelation. One day you see and say, this one, this house is yours. This house is yours. This one too is yours. That car is yours. That land belongs to you. This one is also yours. It's not because you are fighting and killing for it, but by revelation, amen, God will bring you into abundance. If you believe it, shout amen. Amen. Wow. Beautiful. Are you there still? Yes. Number two, God gave Job a revelation, and he became the richest man in the Far East. In Job 29, he says, oh, that it were with me as in the days of my youth, when the secret of the Lord was upon my tabernacle. My God and my Lord. Job 29, he says from verse 1, moreover, Job continued his parable and said, oh, that I were as in months past, as in the days when God preserved me, when his candle shined upon my head, and when by his light I walked through darkness. As I was in the days of my youth, when the secret of God was upon my tabernacle, when the Almighty was yet with me, and when my children were about me. He was referring to a time in his life that by the secrets of God, he was a great man in town. By those secrets, you will be great. Amen. By the light God gives you, you will shine. Amen. Wow. Job, in chapter 22, he says, acquaint now thyself. So he gives a prescription to every one of us. Acquaint now thyself. Get to know God. Yes, labor to know God. Don't labor to run away from church. Run away from preaching. Run away from the word. Run away from anything that has to do with God, the Bible, church, and everything. That you run away because you feel that it's a waste of time. They are just chopping your money. They are just wasting your time. But brother, mark my words. It is these words that will give you life. And you will have life more abundantly. Your amen is weak, oh. So Job said, acquaint now yourself with God. Know God. And thereby you will be at peace. Number two, he says, receive the word. I pray you receive the word from his mouth and lay up his words in thine heart. Wow. Receive his word. That's why we are preaching today. That's why we are preaching today. That's why we are preaching today. That's why we are preaching today.
Amen.
And we are preaching because God's word is powerful.
That's right.
Isaiah 48, verse 18. He says, Oh, that thou hast hearkened to my commandments. Oh, that thou hast hearkened. That's what Job was saying. Yes. Receive, I pray you. He said, I'm begging you.
Wow.
And God is saying, oh, that thou hast hearkened to my commandments. Are you all hearkening? When you hear the word of God, it doesn't mean much to you. When you hear the word of God, it's as though somebody is just saying something to just con you. But brothers and sisters, if you only hearken to his commandments, then your peace would have been as a river and your righteousness as the waves of the sea. Thy seed also had been as the sand and the offspring of thy bowels like the gravel thereof. His name should not have been cut off nor destroyed from before me. 20. Go ye forth to Babylon, flee ye from the Chaldeans, with a voice of singing declare ye. Tell this, utter it even to the end of the earth. Say ye, the Lord hath redeemed his servant Jacob. Verse 21. And they tested not when he led them through the deserts. When God is leading you, you will not test.
Amen.
Even if it's in the desert, where it is dry, where there is no water, if God is leading you, he can lead you. It can be a desert, but I tell you, you will see that you'll be drinking.
Amen.
You will drink.
Amen.
You will not test again.
Amen.
You will not test again.
Amen.
You will not hunger again.
Amen.
If God is the one leading you, I'm telling you. You see, but because you feel that it's like it's too much, you see, that's why I say labor is not easy. It's not something that's just there that as soon as you go and they lay hands on you and then they stay there, receive money, then immediately money is just flowing. It's you labor, you work hard for revelation, insight, something that is shocking, something that's surprising, something that makes you say, wow, something that makes you stand, something that makes you clap your hands and say, wow, what a word is this? Then from that day, you change your lifestyle based on the word you have heard. You see that you'll be rising. You'll be going higher and higher. Oh, that thou hast hearkened unto his commandments. If only you have hearkened. So Joseph, receive his word, I pray you, and it will be a blessing for your life. Then what will happen? You will lay up gold like dust. Job 22:24. Then thou shalt lay up gold like as dust, and the gold of Ophir as the stones of the brooks. Hey, you are going to receive gold.
Amen.
You see, you say, what's the relationship between the word you are preaching and the gold you are talking about? Sit down. You sit down. Receive, I pray you, the word from his mouth. It is that word that is light. And it is that light that will make you shine.
Amen.
There's nobody who has light who walks in darkness. Unless you turn off your light, darkness cannot overcome you. For the light shines in the darkness. And the darkness does not overcome the light. So it doesn't matter which darkness it is. Whether it is poverty darkness. Whether it is marital darkness. Whether it is what type educational darkness. Somebody didn't look after you darkness. I mean background darkness. Family darkness. I mean witches in your family. Wizards in your family. I mean people who don't want you to go on at your workplace. The darkness of people who are always working against you, nobody like, no matter the darkness, light will shine through the darkness.
Amen.
And the darkness will never overcome it.
Amen.
Seek that light.
Amen.
Seek that light. Satoki paradasinde. You lay up gold like dust. And verse 25 says, yea, the Almighty shall be your defense, and thou shalt have plenty of silver. Gold is like a millionaire, a dollar millionaire, and silver is like a seedy millionaire. Because dollar millionaire is gold, it's like you are high up there. And the seedy millionaire, you are also there. You are silver. You are loaded with silver. You are only yearning to have the money, but you are not yearning for the revelation that will bring you into that wealth. Say, my eyes are opening. Then he says, God will hear your prayer. Thou shalt make thy prayer unto him, and he shall hear thee, and shall pay your vows. And verse number 7 says, when men are down, you will be exempted. He says in verse 29, when men are cast down, then thou shalt say, there is lifting up, and he shall save the humble person. People who are depressed will come to you for comfort. You don't believe it, you see. Or you feel that to be too much of a burden. People who are sad will come to you and you will be their comfort. You will say, there is a lifting up. It is well with you, my brother. It is well with you, my sister. God will make a way for you as he made a way for me. If he do for me, he go do for you. If he do for you, he go do for her. Whatever he has done for one person, God will do it again. Only you can believe it. We've been walking in this faith, and we have become the envy of many journalists and other Christians who are a certain way. But there are Christians who don't really believe the Bible. And when you take on the Bible and God is lifting you up, it pains them. They want to join unbelievers to criticize pastors and say all kinds of things. Don't worry. As you are criticizing, we are advancing. As you are criticizing, you are not the first, you probably not be the last. The people who have been criticizing pastors, you will see that you are there. You will see the pastor advancing, more building more churches, traveling more, preaching more, raising more shepherds, more pastors, winning more souls. I mean, advancing as you keep talking. I've been in this church since 1987, 1988, 1987, 1988, 1996, 1986, 1987, 1988. Some of you are listening to me, don't even know. You are trying to calculate where you were. They criticized my bishop, criticized, talked about him, said so many things, wrote letters from the medical school, wrote letters to the authorities, they should stop this church, close it down, wrote letters to the school where we're meeting, having service. They told the principal, close it down. The principal said, hey, as long as I am the principal of this school, there will always be a church here. He pinned them, Papa. I don't know where all those critics are, but the one they were criticizing, he is still advancing. He is still advancing. It's been more than 30 years. You have just come and you have started criticizing. And some of you are even in the church. You join the critics to criticize. Yes. They are looking at me watching this thing. You criticize the church. You say bad things about our prophet and the bishop. You think that brings a blessing? The Bible says that curse not the king. No, not in thy bedchamber. That means don't say bad things about a leader of your people. A leader, a pastor, a leader of the people. Curse not the king. A bird of the air shall fly and tell him. When you speak in your bedchamber, he will hear it. And it will not be good for you. Yes. It will not be good for you. Masate kiria baba. Nonche mama rabike totenimida. Hallelujah. Now, number 3. So first is Jacob. He had a revelation through a dream. Second was Job. He got his revelation through the scriptures. That's why I say receive his word. Lay it upon your heart. Yes, because the scriptures have revelations. Me myself, I remember Bishop saying many times that in 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 15 is the secret or the key that ushered him into full-time ministry as he was reading the scriptures in the morning. You read the scriptures in the morning, you do nothing with it. He says in 1 Timothy 4:15, meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Today, his profiting is appearing to all. So you jealous, you go die. I say you jealous, you go die. Don't be jealous. What is the secret that has turned a medical student? And some people say that, hey, if he's a doctor, he should go and be a doctor and forget, stop ministry. You see, because you don't have revelation. He has revelation. It is revelation, a revelation that made him drop his medical career. And counted, he said, and I count all things that were gained to me, I counted them by dung. You don't have that revelation. What to fear now, count as yourself. How will it be well with you? What to fear now? You are speaking. Oh, when you see a man of God, just say bad things about him. If you see a pastor, you just say bad things about him. And there are some of the bishops that you ordained who left the church recently, who are writing things on Facebook. And some of you who are watching me, you have been reading it, and you feel that you are confused. You are not mature. That's why. And I tell them, those who you are ordained, you are not the first. You will not be the last. People were before you who criticized your father, and you whom he ordained and put a bishop on you. You call yourself a bishop, and you have the audacity to say bad things about the one who laid hands on you, the one who birthed you into ministry, the one who trained you, the one who loved you and cared for you, and he has loved them even to the end. To fear now, church from Kwasiasem. So I was in the system when you are there, the system is very tight, and the system is this. Hypocrite. You be quiet, don't talk, because you don't understand spiritual things, because you are not mature. That's why you take up a man of God and write, not even talk, but write it and publish it in there. You are not the first. You will not be the last. But I just want you to be careful, because you are not going to go very far with what you are doing. You feel that you are the one who can correct a man of God. I say, it's been 30 years we are in this church. 30 years, there were people who wrote. They wrote letters. They wrote to authorities. They wrote to classmates. They signed. Several, they signed. Published it. You are just coming after 35 years or 30 years to come and also start a new fight. How can you even begin it? Say somebody loves you and you return the love with hatred. Do things that will attract a blessing, not things that attract, but what you are doing, it attracts a curse. Even if he doesn't curse you, you sit there and say that he's sitting somewhere cursing his children. What you have done and what you are doing is what attracts a curse, not what he will say. If he doesn't even open his mouth, it will affect you. When you don't honor your father, it's not your father who has to curse you. God is the one who has said that. If you don't honor your father and your mother, it will never be well with you in this life, and your days will not be long. I didn't write it. It is in Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 2. Now you are in the church and you hear people criticizing your bishop, then you also say, I'm a bit confused, you know. I don't know what to believe. You don't know what to believe. You don't know what to believe. Then study the Bible carefully, so that you can know what to believe. You won't study the Bible. That's why you will say you are confused. The person has a revelation. He walks on, writes on revelation. He says, since God told him, honor Archbishop Duncan Williams, he has never ceased to honor him. Various things have even happened that could mar the relationship. But he said, no way. Once God has said this to me, it's a revelation in my heart. Nobody can change it. Because God told me, you don't have that conviction. You are not strong on your conviction. You can't say, Bishop, that was my father, and today you say he's no longer my father. There's nothing like that. You are not mature. That's why you will be saying such things. honor your father to be well with you. You see, it hasn't come to you as a revelation. It's a sentence in the Bible. It's a memory verse. But it's not a revelation. It hasn't hit you. That's why there are some of you, you are watching me, you still have a bad relationship with your father. Because this particular sentence is not a revelation. It's not it has not come to you as a surprising, interesting, important fact that you must live your life by. It's not something that you are governing yourself with. So still, you have your father there, your mother. You still insult them. You still say bad things about them. If your father was to send you, you would say, I won't go. Calling you say, oh, me kobe biya na o, what's out of this? I will not go anywhere. I won't go anywhere. Then you throw your hand and wave your hand in his direction. Even though he can't see you, God has seen the waving of your hand. Let it come as a you see, pray for it. Work hard for it. Let it hit you and say, wow. No matter what your father does, even if he's a drunkard, even if he's in prison, because of this revelation, even if he's in prison, my father is in prison. Even if he's a drunkard, my father is drunk, he's in the gutter. I'm going for daddy. I'm going for daddy. A brother told me the other day, he said, thank you for preaching about honoring fathers. My siblings and I, we didn't have much to do with him because he didn't look after us. See, a father didn't look after you will not negate this verse if it is a revelation for you. But because you preached, one day I went to look for him. When I went, he was paralyzed. He couldn't do anything for himself. There was nobody around. He weed on himself, pooped on himself. I cleaned, I washed, I did everything, stayed with him, looked after him. It wasn't long after he died. And I said, what you have done, tears were even in my eyes as I was talking. I was moved. Even now as I'm talking, I feel very emotional about it. I was so moved. I said, hey, what you have done. Maybe he didn't even leave you land. But Jalil, you have more than lands. Maybe he never gave you a car or a house. But I tell you, the act of honoring this man who didn't look after you, but you went to look for him and looked after him till he died, God will bless you. You learn it. If you don't learn it, if you don't catch it, you will see that you will meet something you can't control. Maso pata katariada. Masonde.
I receive it.
Ah, I can see Nana Kweku is saying it's a deliverance service. Yes, it is. Somebody says, is it a deliverance service? Yes, it is. Because somebody today is being delivered from a curse. The fourth one, the first was Jacob, isn't it? The second was Job. The third is Daniel. Daniel chapter 5. Belshazzar was a king in Babylon. And the Bible says, he inherited the throne from his father. And his father had caused them to bring the goblet and the golden utensil that Solomon had dedicated to God for God's service. The silver vessels, the golden vessels which were dedicated. They went to capture, because when they went to capture the Israelites, they collected all these things from the temple and brought it to Babylon. But his father there, he kept them in a store. But his son, the boy, he got up and said, Kai, my father has these nice silver and golden wares that he brought from this day he never used. As for my father, dear, he likes keeping things he doesn't use. I'm going to use them. So he had the party, and then he called all the lords, the princes, their wives, and the kings around, and they came and they were drinking. And they were, it's like something that they have dedicated to God, like maybe a glass that is dedicated to God. So he picked it and he was drinking from it, and they were laughing, quack, 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 and the girls were sitting on them, and they were laughing, they were jumping, they are happy. Hey! Then suddenly, a small hand came and started on top of, there was a golden candlestick, and it started writing in the plaster. You see, the paint is on the plaster of a wall. In the plaster, we plaster the wall before we paint. So the plaster of the wall, he started writing in the plaster. A small hand, no arm and no human body, but the hand was just there like this, like this, like this. Hey! Did he understand the writing, the language, not the, and the meaning of the language, but he knew that something was wrong. Because a hand cannot just be in the air and writing on the wall like that. So he, the Bible says his knees began to knock against each other. So he called the magicians, the astrologers, and the wise men of the town. And he said, interpret the writing for me. I don't know what it means, but I feel that there's something wrong. Something is not correct. Then came all the king's wise men, but they could not read the writing nor make known to the king the interpretation thereof. Then was the king Belshazzar greatly troubled, and his countenance was changed. Daniel chapter 5, we are reading from verse 8. Daniel chapter 5, we are reading from verse 8. Then the Bible says, verse 9, that then was the king Belshazzar greatly troubled, and his countenance was changed in him, and his lords were astonished. You see, there are even words we are seeing we have not seen before. Astonished. Verse 10. Now the queen, say the queen, by reason of the words of the king and his lords, came into the banquet house. And the queen spake and said, O king, live forever. Let not thy thoughts trouble thee, nor let thy countenance be changed. There is a man in thy kingdom, in whom is the spirit of the holy gods, and in the days of thy father light and understanding and wisdom like the wisdom of the gods was found in him, whom the king Nebuchadnezzar thy father, the king, I say, thy father, made master of the magicians, astrologers, Chaldeans, and soothsayers, for as much as an excellent spirit and knowledge and understanding, interpreting of dreams and showing of hard sentences and dissolving of doubts were found in the same Daniel, whom the king named Belteshazzar. Now let Daniel be called, and he will show the interpretation. There is a man in thy kingdom. There is a woman in your company. There is a brother in your establishment. There is somebody in the corporation. There is a little boy in the house. The Bible says that in whom is the spirit of the holy gods. Yes. And in the days of thy father, light and understanding, light, revelation, light, understanding, wisdom. These are the things that are in the Holy Spirit. Spirit of wisdom, spirit of understanding, light, revelation. Spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. These are in the Holy Spirit. That's why pray for the Holy Spirit. Spend time with the Holy Spirit. Ask him specifically, what is the way to go as a little boy who is serving his father in the house? What is the way to go as a wife in the house who is with the husband? What is the way to go as a husband with a difficult wife? What is the way to go as somebody who works for somebody in his company? What is the way? What should I do for a pastor who wants his church to grow? You have to meet the Holy Spirit and lights and understanding and wisdom in the area where you are requesting. He will give it to you. He can interpret hard sentences and he can dissolve doubt. So then was Daniel brought in before the king. And the king spake and said unto Daniel, art thou that Daniel which art of the children of the captivity? You see, you may be children of the captivity. Your pedigree or your CV is a slave, somebody who was captive, a prisoner, a captured from battle and captured from war. It doesn't matter. You see, some of you are so concerned about how people talk about you and what they say about you. It doesn't matter. What people say is not their point. What people say is not what matters. Every day you want to spoil the church, and they're like that talking about me. They say I'm like this. They say, are you of the one of the captivity of Judah, whom the king my father brought out of Jewry? That means they're from the Jews. I have even heard of thee that the spirit of the gods is in thee, and that light. One day your boss will say that I see that there's some light in you. And understanding and excellent wisdom is found in thee. And now the wise men, the astrologers, have been brought in before me that they should read the writing and make known the interpretation, but they couldn't. verse 16, I have heard of thee that thou canst interpret. You see, I've heard of you that you can interpret and dissolve doubts. Now if thou canst read the writing and make known unto me the interpretation, thou shalt be clothed with scarlet. You see, prosperity. You'll be clothed with red scarlet. It's not kotoko, it's scarlet. It's royalty. And have a chain of gold about thy neck. Gold, the gold of Ophir. And shall be the third in command. Your status is going to change. I see a status change. Your status is changing. From a servant, you are becoming a master. From a messenger, you are becoming a manager. From a manager, you are becoming a chief executive. From a stubborn wife, you are becoming a lovely wife. Your status is changing. No more declining. I'm on my way to better days. My status is changing. No more decline. You see, this is it. I'm on my way to better days. Better days, better days. You will receive better days. You will experience better days. You will experience better days. Then answer. Listen to Daniel's answer. Then answered and said, Daniel said before the king, let thy gifts be to thyself. I'm not interested in your gifts. I'm not doing this for money. We are not doing this for gold around our neck. Contrary to what people think, we are not preaching because we want money and offerings from you, brother. If Bishop Dag wanted money, this is not what he should be doing. No. He has mates in that. He would have gone. He's a Swiss born. His mother is Swiss. He's half Swiss, half Ghanaian. He doesn't have to struggle for visa like many Ghanaians have struggled for visa to go to America or Switzerland. If he needed money, he can go to Switzerland. Doctors are instant millionaires when they arrive in Switzerland. America. I know many of our pastors and brothers, they are loaded. They don't struggle for money. But you are doing ministry. It's not for money. Say, let thy gifts be to thyself. If you don't want to even give offering, don't give offering, but receive the word. But if you receive your word and you are humble, power means the word will come alive in you. And you start giving as though they are forcing you to give. Nobody will force you to give. But if the word is alive and you have a revelation on giving, you will always give a good offering. Let thy gifts be to thyself and give thy rewards to another. Yet I will read the writing unto the king and make known to him the interpretation. Verse, this thing says, O thou king, the Most High God gave Nebuchadnezzar thy father a kingdom, a majesty and glory and honor. And for majesty, whatever he did, you see, so he went on and then he read the writing for him. We told him that many tekel ufasin. Hey, tongue, so many tekel ufasin, many tekel ufasin, many tekel ufasin. It's tongues. Many tekel ufasin, many tekel ufasin, many tekel ufasin. So sometimes when people are speaking in tongues, it's at this type of, you don't understand the writing. He says that many means that you have been weighed in the balance and you have been found wanting. God has numbered your kingdom and finished it. Many. And then Tekel says, thou art weighed in the balances and art found wanting. Perez, thy kingdom is divided and given to the Medes and the Persians. Then commanded by Shaza. You see, he didn't even wait. He commanded they should clothe Daniel with scarlet. Put a chain. The man says, I don't want that thing. Give it to somebody. Say, oh, no. You must get the prosperity by force. You must get the status change by force. They put a gold scarlet. They change his clothes. They put a gold chain around his neck. And then they proclaim throughout the kingdom that he should be the third ruler in the kingdom. Fantastic. You want to be promoted, isn't it? But you're always talking about your colleagues. It's like you feel that if you talk about them and say bad things and look good before the authorities, then you are the one who will be lifted up. It's a wrong way. You are laboring in the wrong direction. When you fall, your fall will be too great. Promotion, it comes by light. God gave him that light. Joseph, number 5, the last one. Joseph. Mato karata sibiale. Ripato sandini mikiba. Hey, sato kabari andalaba. My God and my Lord. Look at Genesis 41. Genesis 41. God gave a supernatural revelation to Joseph that made him become a prime minister. God gave Daniel a supernatural revelation that made him prosper. Now God gave Joseph a supernatural revelation that made him become a prime, from prison to prime minister. Genesis 41, look at verse 15. Now the king had a dream, just like Nebuchadnezzar. And he said, I have dreamed a dream, and there is none that can interpret. You see, people want you to interpret their dreams. Up to today, people still dream and they want to toss the interpretation to us. And I have heard say of thee that thou canst understand a dream to interpret it. And Joseph said, it is not in me. It is not what? But it is where? God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace. God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace. God shall give Pharaoh an answer of peace. So he shared his dream with Joseph. He shared his dream with Joseph. And we can't go through all the dream. The dream, a fat cow, seven lean cows, they came to eat up the fat ones, and so on. Many long dream. Long dream. But verse 39. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph. Okay. Backtrack a bit. Because this one is the final, the showdown, the last show of the movie. We can't do the last show. Let's watch small from verse. Yeah. And Joseph said unto Pharaoh, the dream of Pharaoh is one. God has showed Pharaoh he's about to do. Seven good, blah, 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 blah. Let's go to verse 30. Go down. And there shall arise 7 years of famine and all that. Verse 31. And for that the dream was doubled unto Pharaoh. He had it twice. It is because the thing is established by God, and God will shortly bring it to pass. You see, labor for revelation. Pray for insights from God. Either through a dream or a message or a scripture you are reading or somebody talking to you. Sometimes we can advise you, but because you lack the spirit of counsel, you can't hear. Now therefore, let Pharaoh look out a man discreet and wise and set him over. Oh. And set him over the land of Egypt. Let Pharaoh do this, and let him appoint officers over the land, and take up the fifth part of the land of Egypt in the seven plenteous years. And let them gather all the food of those years that shall come, and lay up corn under the hand of Pharaoh, and let them keep food in the cities. And that food shall be for store to the land against the 7 years of famine, which shall be in the land of Egypt, that the land perish not through the famine. And the thing was good in the eyes of Pharaoh and in the eyes of all his servants. They saw that now. Interpretation is correct for 3 points. Okay, 10 points. You will give interpretation, there will be problems in the office, problems in the house. You will be given the interpretation, the solution. And when you land it, you see that is trodo perfect. And Pharaoh said unto his servants, can we find such a one as this? A man in whom the spirit of God is. You see, that's what we are looking for. Somebody in whom is the spirit of God. Not somebody talk. You know, we are doing leverage, and you know, you have financial engineering, and you know, and you see that the political landscape and the stakeholders and a lot of talking. We are looking for somebody who is full of the Holy Ghost, but the believers are not full of the Holy Ghost. They are full of wine. They are full of pornography. They are full of useless chatter. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, for as much as God hath showed thee all these things. See, that's revelation. God has showed an interesting and surprising fact that is shown or revealed to people. God God shows revelations. God gives insight. God gives direction. God can show you, no matter how tight your situation is, God can show you where to go, how to maneuver, how to do it. But you will never wait on God. You will not hear his voice. Some of you are using just your tribal feelings and tribalisms and traditions of tribes and traditions of nations and everything to run your life, not the word of God. So daily you are not seeking what is the revelation in this. If I and pray, you see that you labor, say praise, because you can be given there, but you will not do it. A key can be given you that can change your life forever, but you will never follow it. Then Pharaoh said unto Joseph, for as much as God has showed thee all this, there is none so discreet and wise as thou art. Beautiful. Thou shalt be over my house, and according unto thy word shall all my people be ruled. Only in the throne will I be greater than thee. Powerful. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, see, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. God has given you revelation. Now take over. God has given you revelation. Take over. Revelation will make you take over. Revelation will make you take over. Hey, my God and my Lord. That's why you are sitting down, revelation free. Dancers, don't labor to, you see, your moves are very a lot. You'll be doing so many. You have labored for dance moves, but no revelation. You can dance, but Charlie, after you have danced, go and sit down, take the Bible and say, Lord, show me how to be a good worker, a good servant, a good laborer, a good mason. How? Show me. Pastor Francis, he said he got a collection of tapes from some pastors who were traveling to Fiji and so on. Papua New Guinea. They left the tapes for him. So he started listening. Then one of the things he heard Bishop say, it's not everybody you work for that you charge. A message. I told you. He said, it's not everybody you work for. And he was a contractor. Contractors charge all the time. Inflate prices, try to get money. Everybody, all contractors always inflate. Cement is 38, they'll say it's 41. But they know you'll not go to the market to ask. When he heard, it is not everybody you work for that you charge. He armed himself with that revelation. Is it to you to say, how can it be possible that, I mean, hey, then how are we going to eat? That's my work. I have to eat from my work. How can I work and not charge? I must charge all the time. That's your wisdom. Cease from your own wisdom. So he armed himself. I met him. He was working, he was visiting Bishop Asu in his house, and I was around. And I said, who is this guy? So he's a builder. So wow, can he build? Okay, then he should build for me. And I was trying to honor a father in my life when I gave him the contract to build that house. He never charged. It's like materials. We buy the materials. I never hear labor charge. So one day I said, I owe a lot because I know materials is what I have been buying, but where is the labor? He said, you don't owe me anything. I said, me? I owe you. He said, no, you don't owe me. I said, how? He was arming himself. He was running with, it is not everybody you work for that you charge. That is the revelation he's running on. So he's not charging me. He finished building. I handed over the keys to the father I wanted to honor. And I blessed him. I said, you are blessed. Later on, we are building an akazu. And we were looking for people to, if we knew of contractors. I said, I know of a guy. That It's not everybody you work for that you charge guy. I'm going to call him. So I called him. Are you working somewhere? Can you do another job? So, oh, Bishop, I can. This is maybe more than 10 years ago. He's been working for Anakazu till Anakazu was finished. He's still working. He's laboring. He's never finished eating. Because the revelation that it's not everybody you work for that you charge. Even some of you don't know that. If you work for somebody and let's say you have to charge 40 CDs or 20 CDs and you tell the person that, oh dear, I won't charge you. Whatever is from your heart, give to me. You may even get more. And will be called several times. Instead of every day when you go, you have to charge, you know. And some of you, if you work for the day, maybe you should charge 70 CDs. But you say 120 or 250. Because you've got somebody's, like the house looks nice, the people look prosperous, the car is powerful, so you have to charge. Ooh. Then you go and meet somebody who understands these things, say, ah, but if you're amazing, you work for the whole day, how much will you be paid? Is it not 7 days? And you have done this work for only 2 hours, and you are charging me for more than 2 days' work. Oh, why? Okay, here's your 250. Bye-bye. That's it. You have labored for money, but not for blessing. God gave Joseph a revelation of what Pharaoh's dream meant, and he took charge of the whole of Egypt. Took charge. When I saw 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17, he said, for this cause have I sent unto you Timotheus, who is my beloved son and faithful in the Lord, who shall bring you into remembrance of my ways which be in Christ, as I teach everywhere in every church. I said, ah, that's my ministry. For Bishop Dagwood Mills. For this cause have I sent unto you Timotheus, who is a beloved son and faithful in the Lord, who shall bring you into remembrance of all my ways. Whatever his ways are in Christ, as I teach in every church. So what Paul teaches in every church, he should get Timothy and send him to all the churches and make him teach them all the things Paul is teaching in all the other churches. He would teach it as he has been teaching in other churches. I said, oh, that's my ministry. I saw it was a verse, but I took it as mine. Yeah, you don't have a revelation. Why is it that they don't want us to wait on God to get our own revelation? I mean, the Holy Spirit also reveals things to me. Why are they not helping me? You know something? This all time will allow us. But in Isaiah 60, it's your final prophetic word. Verse 1 says, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Revelation has come. The glory of God will rise upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee. His glory shall be seen upon thee. And the Gentiles shall come to your light and kings to the brightness of your rising. May this be your prophetic word. When light comes upon you, may you shine and shine that kings will come to the brightness of your rising. And nations will gather at your feet. Father, I thank you for everyone who has listened to your word. I pray that you will transform and change their lives in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If you want to give your life to Jesus, let me pray with you. If you are listening on the car, you are listening by radio, wherever you are, YouTube, Facebook, I want you to just pray this prayer with me. Say, Heavenly Father, I thank you for today. I come to you just as I am. Please forgive me for all my sins and wash me with your precious blood. From today, I belong to Jesus. I will follow Jesus for the rest of my days. Please write my name in the book of life. I'm yours forever. I'm yours forever. I'm yours forever in Jesus' name. Clap your hands unto Jesus. God bless you. You may be seated wherever you are. It's time for offering, it's time for tithing, and it's time to give. I want all of you to take out a good offering. You see, some of you want to even go off already, but please take out a good offering. Don't say, I just came to listen to the word. But if the word has been a blessing to you, you are supposed to sow into that word so that God can also prosper you through the word. So take out your mobile phones. Even if you go off for a few minutes, that's fine. But come right back so we can take the communion together. God will bless you. Father, thank you for the blessing of giving an offering today. And those of you who are paying your tithe, lift up your right hand. I'm going to pray for you. Father, you declared that when we honor you with our tithe, you will rebuke the devourer for our sakes. Rebuke the devourer for our sakes. And honor your people in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Give your offering *365 *444 # Everybody, please give an offering. Even if I can see so many of you are online, those of you who are in the watch parties, please give your tithe, give your offerings. Those of you who are in the Qedesh, you have not been coming to the office to bring your money, your tithe, please do it through mobile money. And God is going to bless you. Give a good offering wherever you are. God is changing your life. God is changing your status in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. MTN 0595968461. You can send your mobile money through there. If you're on Sweet Melodies, still please give a good offering. You want to wire through the bank also. Fidelity is our bank. 10504061 52318 10504061 52318 It will be a blessing for your life. If you are in the Gambia, you can see it right on your screen. Please give your offering through all the different channels: Gambia, Takwa, Senegal, Guinea, Bissau, Takradi, Sekendi. All of you who are part of the Makarios, and those of you who are watching, you may not be part of the Makarios Church in terms of a denomination, but give an offering to support this great work that we are doing. We are about to move to Dakar. You know, we are building churches still, because a day is going to come, we'll be able to come back to church. So we are still building and preparing. It's like Noah. He's building the ark, preparing. The Bible says that by faith, he built an ark. He prepared himself by building an ark to the saving of his household. So please give a good offering and help us. We are about to move into Dakar. It's all in dollars and very expensive, but we've already built, bought the land, built a wall around it, put a gate, got soil tests, lawyers, everything. We are getting ready to ship our steel and everything so that we can build. It's not going to be a simple project, but we'll do it. Because we are preparing ourselves, because the day is going to come. We are not going to be locked down forever, and church is not going to be closed forever. By all means, we'll come back by the grace of God. And when the time comes, we believe that some of our brethren, by the time we have been released to go, then it's like, hey, your church is ready. Say, what? When did they build this church? How did they come here? Because we are still there. In a good general, the book that Bishop wrote, The Good General, one chapter says that a good general continues fighting in the midst of panic and fear. Even when there's war and you have to build, he builds. He's fighting and he's building like Nehemiah. God is going to bless us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.